KUAM News, brought to you by GTA. We start with you. Subway and Chili's Grill and Bar.
I didn't throw him under the bus. He ran in front of the bus.
Palacios says the governor should speak for himself to clear the air in the legislative probe into his administration's spending. And at a press briefing this morning, Torres sounds off.
I've told him since the beginning. I said, hey, call me in so we can hash this out and answer those questions, the concerns that you have. Yet it's been several months. They never did that. They're choosing to go this route. They brought in officers. They brought in people that are subpoenaing other people. And yet they haven't called me. So apparently they already have a goal, an agenda before all this process.
He'll wait until the subpoena, which was approved by the House committee, reaches his desk.
He testified under oath. Would you say that he gave a truthful testimony?
Well, I guess if there's anything that is inaccurate or incomplete, then we have to see that. I don't want to be the one to say whether it's accurate or not.
Committee Chairwoman Selena Babauta says more witnesses are on the way.
We still have to go through a few other witnesses for the JGO hearings before we issue the subpoena for the governor. Next Tuesday, we will have Gary Camacho, Executive Director for the Commonwealth Utilities Corporation, and he was issued his subpoena last Friday, a week ago. And so far we have not received any communication that he will be coming with an attorney or, you know, as with some other witnesses in the past, they have not notified us whether they will be speaking in vernacular or in English.
She says they'll have questions about utility bills in the thousands for the governor's home and other accounts under his name. Island Media asked Torres if he's considered resigning.
Absolutely not.
Tomas Mangwanya for KUAM News.